asking about the bao, and I was explaining that almost every Kung Fu style, the idea, the meaning of what the style is actually in the bao. The bao is like an opening statement in a thesis. It gives the idea, it explains conceptually what's going on, and how well you do the bao actually shows how well you understand your style. So in our bao, in Hong Ga, right? Here, okay? Just from there, there's a lot of meaning, right? First off, meaning number one is applications, okay? So he grabs my wrist, right? I can come here and break and hit, okay? That's one application. Another application is he punches, I come here, I grind, and I hit here. Right? So those are just some of the basic ideas of just applications alone. Okay? Why does this come out at this weird angle? Right? That's the best way to come at this angle. Okay. So if I'm throwing a straight punch and he's blocking, right? Other hand. See, straight punch. If I throw a hook, he's gonna block out, right? How can you tell? It's because of how my shoulder turns. If I go this way, he misses coming this way. If I go here, straight, so straight, hook, right here, straight, as he goes to block, it hooks and it goes around. Okay, that's why the bao is at this weird angle, because it's hooking around as much. So that's just sheer application, the meaning of the bao. You wanted to know, the question was, how many things are in the bao? Okay. All right, check this out. Our bao, tiger, they call it the tiger and dragon commandment. It's literally the tiger claw. This says a lot about the whole system. Right? If you have something favorite, like your favorite object, and you have a cabinet or something like that, your favorite things are on top. Your least favorite things are usually on bottom, right? So we say top shelf when something's good. Now, palm strike or tiger claw, generally speaking, is a shorter range technique. If I punch him like this, it's gonna flush. This is how I can aim for my punch. My tiger claw, my palm can hit, can reach him, right? Because it's bent back. See? Okay, but in our bao, there's a secret meaning. They're both at the same distance. What's up with that? Why did they do that? Watch. When we punch, our back is straight in Hong Kong. We don't punch over. We don't sink in our chest when we punch. However, when we hit with our palm, we do that. We always do that. That's the way the tiger moves. This is why. If I hit him here and my back is straight, I can reach this distance. If I push my chest in, I can still hit him. So the tiger claw and the punch, they're equally important. They're equally the same distance. We play them both at the same distance. But wait, there's more. How much stuff can be in a bao? Okay? All right, so the other thing is the bao has a special meaning. A lot of Kung Fu baos have the same. They say, I believe it's the four C's. When the four C's and the five legs come together, all men are brothers. So you guys know this is our regular bao, right? Okay, all right, watch. Here, okay. This symbolizes the four C's, 1, 2, 3, 4. This symbolizes the five lakes. So it's talking about the big bodies of water in China, right? And remember, this was built by a rebellious society. So the symbolism is when the four C's and the five lakes come together, all men are brothers. If we unite the kingdom, we all come together, we're one. And that's the bao here, okay? And that's just some of the stuff that's in the bao, right? Also, the bao takes two steps forward. It takes two steps back. That means I have the aggression and the courage to go into battle. It means I have the wisdom to take two steps back and retreat or avoid conflict. So I'm a complete warrior, a complete person. Right? And there's a lot more. So, did that answer your question? There's a lot of stuff in the bao, okay? So, depending on the system, you can tell exactly how much they know by how they do the bao. Sounds good?